Stand back to the upper.
Ready, camera one.
I'm gonna have to read.
Number two next, you ready?
Kirk Storm, and welcome to the Jersey City Insider, the show on the fabulous JC1 TV network that first brought you a Metropolis Reborn, the formidable sleuth in Discover Jersey City, and last year's special report, all fabulous glimpses into the wondrous things that are occurring in New Jersey's shining star, Jersey City. Behind me, I stumbled into yet another big scoop. We've discovered the place to be in this great city, and the Jersey City Insider has pulled some strings to get us inside to find out what it is that makes this the place to be in the most happening city these days in the Northeast.
As the paparazzi buzzes their flashes, we see the who's who of the great city of Jersey City, once again convening on the subtle but yet place to be in the city, Cafe Jersey City. We here at the Insider are told by those on the waiting list, just go inside the cafe and see what's going on. I and my photographer just got to the nearest corner, so we could stay out of the way and just listen to the gossip and what brings everyone to this locale. This menu has all kinds of things. No wonder you see all kinds of people here. I've heard this is the most diverse city in the country, and if I had to base that upon the people waiting to get inside, that's clearly true.
Connected to Ellis Island by a footbridge, the place that was once the landing spot for the great immigration periods in American history, it's no wonder that this city, more than others, is the embodiment of a cultural and ethnic smorgasbord. Once a stronghold for the early Dutch settlers and the Native American inhabitants, the waves of immigrants to the once formidable rail yard and factory-based warehouse community set the foundation for a metropolis that has more than 50 languages and twice that many dialects spoken regularly in its schools. It would take the skills of a legendary artist, a Leonardo da Vinci or a Van Gogh perhaps, to truly appreciate the colorful ethnic tapestry that has been woven here. Perhaps this mesh has become the true strength of the city's longevity as one of America's oldest cities, be it its European, African, Asian, and Middle Eastern influences, you would be hard-pressed to find a community as rich in diversity and as splendid in the array of its spectrum the people here represent.
This place must be magical, because I don't know where that voice came from, but that was pretty informative.
Tell me about your appetizers. I want something really special.
You won't be disappointed.
One appetizing reality about Jersey City is that it lures people from around the globe due to its proximity to New York, the epicenter of the world's business and cultural institutions. From any point in the city, you're just minutes away from downtown Manhattan, and your means of getting there are very convenient, be it the five ferry ports, the accessible Holland Tunnel, the four stops along the PATH rail system in the city's midst, or the plentiful and always available bus and taxi services. Accessing the hub of the greatest workforce on the planet is just that easy. But there are other appetizing treats in the city that lie on the western shore of the Great Hudson River. It is a business-friendly community which actually sweetens the deal for businesses seeking to relocate here via grants, financial incentive plans, and a robust urban enterprise zone initiative that offers a 3.5% sales tax with participating businesses and infuses part of that reduced sales tax cash flow back into the city. UEZ has been the engine behind the development of Main Street projects throughout the city, which offer a financial and aesthetic infusion into struggling or failed commercial districts that are now prospering once again. And what an appetizing feature the UEZ has become for shoppers throughout the region. A collective of shops, department stores, and trendy boutiques, or what is called first-class goods and services at half the tax.
Today?
Actually, just tell me about your specials.
The meat and potatoes of Jersey City's renaissance are clearly its ability to produce more than 30,000 new jobs the last two decades, careers mostly involved in the financial and securities industry. Jersey City is a jobs-creating machine run wild, with seemingly no end in sight. And housing these financial dynasties, such as Chase, Merrill Lynch, and Goldman Sachs, are skyscrapers that are pushing the city's prestige and skyline to ever impressive new heights. Currently, Jersey City has the state's four tallest buildings in its midst, and soon the sixth tallest with the completion of ongoing projects.
I think the rest of the world has discovered the tremendous assets that we have here in Jersey City, and as a result, businesses are flocking here, residents are flocking here, investment is flocking here, and that's all good for our city.
A still expanding and evolving inner city transportation system via the light rail has enabled the city to remain fluid as it absorbs a still growing new workforce. But what is a workforce to do once the long day has ended? Simple. Go home and relax in one of the more than 15,000 new units of housing built with the promise of much more to come. The accommodations, however, are far more rewarding than the row houses that were built to bed the rail yard supported blue-collar families of yesterday. No, today housing offers a great deal of comforts one would normally see at a vacation resort. With the Golden Trump Tower near completion, it's clear that Donald Trump kept his word when he said he discovered Jersey City some years ago and couldn't wait to make his mark here. Now, a planned second Trump Tower is set to move forward and join its golden brother in the city's skyline. But already complete in parts are some of the greatest luxury offerings in the Garden State. And one such entree features the largest historic restoration and modernization project of its kind in the world. The metamorphosis of the former 10-building Jersey City Medical Center into a plush existence where your every need is just a phone call away to the 24-hour concierge service. This rebirth of this city treasure has been a painstaking ordeal in Center City, a meticulous effort to maintain a distinct chapter in Jersey City's history, but still look forward to the commitment of urban renewal. The Beacon, indeed, is a glowing example of how the prosperity of the city's Gold Coast waterfront has taken root in the rest of the city, leading many of the city's new workforce to go west, young man or woman, into the shining neighborhoods of a city emerging as the destination city in the Northeast. And while the Beacon serves as just that, a shining light and a true example of historical preservation appropriately blended with a rebirth and redevelopment, there are many other examples in Jersey City also underway, even further west into the city. The former municipal courthouse, built in 1925, will see a new day in the near future as it becomes a mixed-use property comprised of condominiums and retail space. And finally, even further west and approaching the city's Silver Coast, lays the resurrection of the former American Can Company buildings, which once served as an industrial titan in the region. Now, they'll become luxurious and special lofts that are unparalleled in the city.
Tell me about your desserts.
You have anything exotic?
Ah, yes, the treats of the city. The desserts and specialties that entice the workforce after a long, hard day, or perhaps bring visitors here over and over again. And should any visitor decide to extend their stay, there are a number of first-class hotels that are awaiting your call with style, comfort, and services associated with only the best in the industry. And speaking of the best, this diverse community has an equally diverse offering when it comes to fine cuisines. All it takes is just a turn of the corner where one can find a wide range of exotic dining locales that are surely to amaze and enliven the palate. Many of these stops double as evening spots to gather, mingle, and ponder the spectrum of ideas. That's why Jersey City is on everyone's top of the list as a spot for dining, social life, living, and just having plain old fun. And if it's pure fun you're seeking combined with a thirst for culture, Jersey City is the spot for the Garden State's largest artist collective, exemplified by an exciting artist museum and by the more than 500 artists who participated in the recent annual studio tour. And then there's the newly expanded and renovated Liberty Science Center, which is home to the largest dome IMAX theater in the United States. The center has thrilled thousands in the past and is sure to be a hotspot for young and old alike, today and into the future, those who are seeking to expand their scientific horizons. And speaking of Liberty, Lady Liberty and historic Ellis Island are just a brief ferry ride away from the amazing Liberty State Park, the site for the passive recreation for families and the front row seat to the annual 4th of July extravaganza. All these treats and more are ready for individuals and families seeking a wonderful time. But very few metropolises across our nation can rival the cherry on top of the cake. That is, the historic reservoir that has now sprung an amazing oasis in the heart of one of the most densely populated cities and counties in the world.
We live in a densely populated state. We have chosen this spot because this is one of the areas we have set aside to preserve as passive recreation and some open space in our city and our county.
Well, there you have it. It appears Cafe Jersey City is a little much like Jersey City itself. It has a little bit of something for everyone's taste. I'm Kirk Storm. For the Jersey City Insider, and I'll see you next time in the city.
Good to be here. Thank you.
In Illinois, this is a heck of a stop. It is a home run, and I definitely will be back.
This menu has everything.
There's no reason to go anywhere else.